Kevin, thank you. To another developing story now. Inspectors today are going over every inch of the roof of Lucas Oil Stadium after last night's incident during the Colts preseason game. Three people injured when a bolt fell into the stands, and it came after witnesses heard a loud pop. RTV6's Katie Hines is getting new details on that for us. Katie.
Todd, the executive director of the Capital Improvement Board, in a statement today, says that safety of everyone who comes here and works here at Lucas Oil Stadium is a top priority. But there's no word on the timeline of that inspection and investigation and whether a recent policy that allows the team to open the retractable roof at halftime will be revisited.
Adam Bowman of Newcastle is a season ticket holder. He cheered on the Colts from section 148 last night. And like other fans, he was excited to hear an announcement the roof would open with 2 minutes left to go in halftime.
It started to open, and it got, I would say, about halfway, maybe very close to halfway. And there was a loud, like, pop. Like, it was a structural, you could definitely tell it was something big, like a big bang.
Bowman didn't see anything fall, but he heard commotion in the section above him.
And you could see the lady had obviously been struck in the head because she was bleeding from the head. And there's another gentleman grabbing his arm.
A total of three people were hurt. Paramedics took two to the hospital, and the third was treated and released on site. None of those injuries are life-threatening. The executive director of the Capital Improvement Board confirms a bolt sheared and dropped into section 248 while the roof was in the process of opening.
When something like this happens, obviously there's a potential there for a fatal injury if it's a large object. So we want to know what, as I said before, what they find out and the actions that they're going to take to prevent something like that from happening again.
City County Councilor Bob Lutz serves on the Municipal Corporations Committee. He says the group will have several questions for the CIB when it presents its budget to the committee later this month. Meantime, Bowman says he plans to attend the next game.
And I don't think it's a problem with the stadium. I think it's just an unfortunate event.
The Capital Improvement Board plans to make more information available once the full inspection of the roof is complete. Reporting live tonight, Katie Hines, RTV6.